is Dr. Esther Trufan, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to decompose baking soda. For this decomposition experiment, we're going to need just a few pieces of equipment. The first thing is going to be a scale. Then we'll need something that is heat resistant, and I'm going to use a Pyrex beaker that is of 400 milliliters. Ideally, you want to use at least a 400 milliliter or larger for this experiment. And then we will measure out, using one of these larger spatulas or scoopula, our baking soda. And then finally, to decompose everything, we're going to need a hot plate so that the heat can drive off the decomposition products. My chemical for this experiment is going to be baking soda. So let's get started. To avoid loss from transfer, I am going to not use weighing boat or a weighing paper, and I'm working with such a large amount that I can transfer it directly into my beaker. The first thing I'm going to do is turn on my scale. And when it shows 0.00, I will place my beaker on top of it. I will record the mass of the beaker as is, because we will come back to this measurement a little bit later. Next, I'm going to place anywhere between 100 to 150 grams of baking soda in the beaker. Now, I can do that using a scoopula, or I can simply transfer it because this is a large amount. I will do a combination of the two. Once I'm satisfied with the amount of baking soda that I added to the beaker, I'm going to record the mass of my beaker and baking soda combined. In my case, this is 254.74 grams. The next step is pretty straightforward. I'm going to set aside my scale and then bring in my hot plate. It is turned to relatively high temperature, because I would like the reaction to succeed in a relatively short amount of time. It will take about 30 to 40 minutes at least for the decomposition to be complete. It will be a good idea to occasionally stir our baking soda as it progresses through the decomposition to make sure that all portions of the baking soda that's in the beaker is getting in contact with the surface of the hot plate through the bottom of the beaker. The first thing that we're going to notice as we are stirring our baking soda inside the beaker is that it will start to clump. This is the result of water forming from the decomposition reaction, and as it forms and it's trying to get through the baking soda layers in the sample, it is going to condense and then cause the clumping of the baking soda. Now we need to keep it on the hot plate, occasionally stirring, until we start observing bubbles and the disappearance of the clumping. It has been a while since I removed our decomposed baking soda, now sodium carbonate, from the hot plate. It cooled down enough that I can comfortably touch it, and the spatula that was inserted, if the reaction ran to completion, it should be easy for the powder to fall off of it. All we have left to do now is to record the final mass of our beaker with now what we hope is sodium carbonate. And then we can move on to calculate the theoretical yield and the percent yield of the decomposition reaction. So for this last step, we need to turn on our scale. And when it says 0.00, we place our beaker with the decomposed baking soda on top of it, and we record a final mass, which for us is 224.20 grams. From the mass, the original mass of the baking soda, and the mass of the resulting, what we hope, pure sodium carbonate, we should be able to calculate everything we need to determine the percent yield of this reaction.